just 17, but he's already a father. And who the mother is will shock you. She used to be his nanny. What is your earliest memory of Marissa, your nanny, crossing the line?
It was a game called Are You Nervous? And the object of that game was she'd place her hand somewhere on my body and I'd say if I was nervous or not. And things escalated from there.
The live-in nanny, Marissa Mowry, was 22 years old. Chris McBride was just an 11-year-old kid, as you can see in this home video.
She said that she loved me. She said that she wanted to date, but she couldn't let anyone know.
Did Marissa make you lie about this?
Yeah, plenty of times. She said, you have to lie or else I'm gonna have to go away.
Chris remembers when his nanny told him she was having his baby.
I was a little bit freaked because I was confused.
This photo shows.
This is what happens when you raise the gas prices and raise the food prices. Look at what's going on here, people. Now all of a sudden they're having a flash sale, right? Look at this. Look at this. Now I'm in Arizona. Where in the hell can you get snow crab clusters for $11.97? Look at all of that. All of a sudden everything sale, 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 sale. You know why? It's because they tried to rape us on these damn prices. Look at all this. Everything's on sale. Sale, sale, sale. That's because they can't sell it. Look, everything's on sale. Everything. All this mess. Look at this. Everything's on sale. Sale, 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 sale. Uh-huh. This is what happens when you try to rob Americans. This is what happens when you try to rob the people and they ain't buying your shit.
These bitches always want something from me. It's way different every time.
So if you're talking about women fumbling good or great men, most women have done this shit. They didn't know any better at the time. They were young and naive and didn't appreciate what this guy was bringing to them. You know, he was a good dude. He wasn't fucking perfect, but he gave a fuck enough to listen and hear you out and try to fix things, which is important. Communication skills were there. And if you needed anything and he could do it, he would. He would make shit happen for you. But since y'all were young and naive, you just didn't give a fuck about it, didn't appreciate it, felt, oh, I want something different, and you traded him in for someone worse, or you traded him in to go and play in the single world to find out, man, there ain't, like, nothing like him. I'm not finding it. Like, what the fuck? Like, so y'all struggle out there. And since you probably sabotaged and fucked up that relationship with this guy, you no longer have access to him. So a lot of women have made this mistake and have fucked this up, and there will always be a little place in their heart for this guy that they righteously fucked over, who wanted nothing but good.
Valerie Sennett has no reason to lie.
Sure she does. For the spoils of war, accuse your husband of abuse and tip the balance in your favor.
The silver bullet strategy.
Also known as sexual assault and divorce. It's very popular these days. You have personal experience?
A divorce lawyer suggested my wife go in that direction, but she didn't hire him.
Well, most men aren't so lucky. I'm not saying there aren't terrified women in need of protection, but there are a lot of vindictive ones who abuse the system under the guise of a divorce strategy. I think your alleged victim is one of them. We'll be right back.
But I really don't understand how a single mom with a one-income household is supposed to survive right now.
I don't understand why all these average men are out here single when they could be coupled up helping you pay the bills, but they weren't good enough, were they? I bet they are now.
When you realize a guy asking, "What do you bring to the table?" is the exact same as him saying, "I have nothing to offer you." False. And welcome to Womansplaining Men to Women, episode 41. If a man asks you this, it is not a personal attack. It is because he has been through it. A man who asks this question has been used so much for what he can offer that he is damn ready for some reciprocity. And when you choose to deflect that question with attack or avoidance, that tells him everything he needs to know about the fact that the jig is up for you. Because at that point, he knows what type of woman you are. This type of woman. A manipulator with her eyes on one thing. And serious question, are these guys affording your lifestyle or your desired lifestyle? Because if you rely on a man to provide that lifestyle, it's not your lifestyle, it's a lifestyle that's being provided for you, usually with conditions. So what he's also asking with that question is, why do you feel so entitled to such a high-value lifestyle? And you can't just say, oh, because women have intrinsic value. Great. So then what makes you different than all of the other intrinsically valuable women? And don't get me wrong, you're allowed to choose which wealth class you will exclusively date in. You're allowed to set any standards you want. And so are men, which is why they can and should be asking you what you bring to the table to ensure that you meet theirs. And ladies, stop taking dating advice from sugar babies. They don't know how to date. They only know how to leech.
Women will 100% pursue the men that they want. Fellas, I need you to understand something. The vast majority of guys in women's eyes are not qualified to date them. So here's the thing. When they find a guy they really like, they're going to do things like this. I'm not ever saying that you should be the guy that's in this video, but I'm saying if she's not putting in effort, she doesn't want you like that.
we're on.
Is it more important than going to college?
It's more, I feel like it's more important to go to college because not everybody goes to college.
You think it's more important to go to college?
To be married and have a life.
Ma'am, you got a college degree, right?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, so what? You got a college degree and no husband. Anybody can be a baby mom. It's like anybody can go to college. It is more important to get to be married than go to college because most people have jobs. We got people who come into this country illegally. Who surpass the people who've been in here for generations because they have family. You're alone as a single woman with a baby. Are you making over $100,000 a year?
I'm not.
Then, ma'am, you are doing it all by yourself. Would it not be better to have a husband and his mother and father, and your mother and father, and all of the extended family that comes along with nuclear families? Even if you were making middle class money, if you had two sets of grandparents and two sets of cousins, would it not be better than single mama degree by yourself?
It would be better, but then it's like, it would be better. I said,
what's the fear though?
I do, but I think it'd be better. Like if we could say it's better if we lived in this perfect world, right?
No, we could say, no, I don't want that perfect world example. We could say it's better if women acted like y'all. We could say,
especially from where I come from.
We could say it's better if women acted like, it's not a perfect world. It's a matter of you ladies staying in your damn place and not leaving your relationships.
This is true, but I mean, men have to do the same though. In a sense.
See, what I want you to understand is this is the same bullshit verbal judo that y'all always do.
Mm-hmm. As far as like just
50, we have a higher than 50% divorce rate, but eight out of ten times women initiate divorce. Women leave relationships, not men. See, what I want you guys to understand is I just asked a very simple question. Which is better, going to college or being married? She knows being married and coming from nuclear families on both sides is better, but she can't say it because it would invalidate what she's doing. So she has to say, no, you need college so you can have a job in case a man leaves you. But the problem is, you ladies are the ones that are wrecking your own homes. You ladies are the ones that are leaving. Men are doing what we're supposed to. Women are out of control today. There's something inside you. It's hard to explain. They're talking about you, boy. But you're still.
On this song. Yeah, really? Yeah, really, Sandy. Fuck off! I'm so annoying. My skin in the beach of America is falling apart, arrogant fucking bitches. Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. This is how the fucking world works. Honey, you know what I'm gonna do tonight? I'm gonna go and heckle an 18-year-old kid that's following his fucking dreams. I should show you that, you're not a good person. Like, jokes aside, you can't go through life like this. It's not fair. It really isn't fair. You can't do this. This is my fucking show, right? Shut the fuck up.
Now what you gonna do? Me and your girl leaving the hotel room.
Roll with me on this, player. First off, thank you. I must thank you. But second part is, if you're leaving the hotel with my girl, you got that phrase wrong. She was already lost the second she entered the hotel with you. Matter of fact, she was already lost the second y'all planned it. She was already lost the second she thought about it, knowing that that's what she was going to get ready to go and do. She wasn't my girl a long time ago. You proved that. So why would I float like a butterfly and sting like a bee with you? That's dumb. I've already lost the war. Wow.
It's crazy, man. I'm talking about all these goddamn you should be talking about. She broke at the goddamn post office. She forgot her bag at home. I followed her. Look what the f*** she is, man. So what you doing, huh? Huh? So what you doing, huh? I followed you because you left your damn bag at the goddamn house.
Give me the damn
bag. I thought you worked at the post office.
I do.
What you doing here then? Huh? What you doing? What you doing here? What the f*** you housekeeping what? What you housekeeping? This ain't no damn, it's a strip club. This is strip, it's clearly saying strip club.
Give me my damn bag.
What you doing now? What you doing here? You're supposed to be at the f***ing post office. Come to find out the post office, you don't even work there overnight. They don't even open. What the hell you doing? What you doing here? What you doing here? Huh? Where you going? What you doing here? Huh? What you doing here? That's what I'm saying.
What are you doing here?
What are you f***ing serious? Are you f***ing serious? Are you f***ing serious? Are you f***ing serious? And you got... What? Oh, are you f***ing serious, bro? Huh? Are you serious? When you start working here? When you start working here? Hey, boy. I'm just saying. Why do you have to strip? You don't have to strip. Do you like this? Are you in it for the money? Like, what are you doing? What are you doing? Because you told me you worked at the post office.
Oh, my goodness. It is the post office.
So I'm
make it shake. You happy?
Why is it so hard for men to be vulnerable with women?
Believe it or not, it's probably the same reason that women are afraid to be vulnerable with men. They've tried to be vulnerable to their partners in the past, and it's blown up in their face. You know, a lot of women act like they have a monopoly on being taken advantage of or being fucked over. That's something that happens to men and women. The difference is, throughout a young woman's life, she's told it's okay to be emotional. She's told it's okay to express her feelings, and she's shown support when she talks about the problems she's having. For a man, that's not the case. And honestly, being an emotional and vulnerable young boy, that's a terrible, terrible thing. Because in our society, it's going to open them up to so much ridicule and so many bad things. And then at some point in our lives, we do find somebody that we want to be vulnerable with. And chances are, that person is no longer with us. They left us after we were vulnerable with them. So if you're wondering why, that's it.
Here are some guy secrets girls don't know about. If you really want to impress your husband/boyfriend, intentionally have side-by-side time with him. Pick an activity or hobby that he enjoys and just do it with him. Don't ask him if he's enjoying himself or what he's thinking. If you have to, literally just sit next to him on the couch and watch the game with him. If he's comfortable with it, quietly watch him build his computer or ask him how it works. Keep the conversation about the activity. Avoid asking him how he's doing unless he brings it up. Literally just be there with him. Ask a guy how his day is. Fine. Ask a guy to explain something about his favorite hobby. You will be there for hours. This is a generalization, but I think there's some truth in it. I think women tend to bond through verbal communication, and they get worried/nervous to just be there with their partner, side by side, because they aren't actually doing anything. But guys see that as bonding and caring.
Understand, when you date a single mom, it's not just her heart you're breaking when you split up. It's yours too, once you review all the debit card purchases you spent to take care of her and her children. Don't be a rent-a-daddy.
This is your $100,000 moment of truth. And this question will not be asked by me. It's by a surprise guest.
Oh my
God. Lauren, can you tell everybody who this is? Or do I need to do it?
I can't speak right now, so.
This is your ex-boyfriend, Frank. Hello, Frank.
How you doing?
Frank has a question for you. And I hope this $100,000, if you win it, is worth this question. If you don't want the answer, you still have the button. I don't need to remind you. This question is for $100,000. When you're ready, question 15.
If I wanted to get back together with you, would you leave your husband?
Hold on. That question is a devastating question.
Of course.
You could avoid this right now by hitting the button, Frank.
No.
No? Okay. Hold on a second. Audience, I know that this is entertaining to watch, but this is real. Frank wanted to hear the answer to this question. Monica, why did you hit the button?
I don't want to hear that answer. I don't think anyone will want to hear that answer.
Okay. I have a question to replace that with. Before I do that, my question to you, Lauren, is, did she just save you or cost you $100,000?
Sure, I don't know.
One of the things that you know if you watch the program is that I will replace the question, but I can't guarantee that that question is going to be any easier. Here's another question that your ex-boyfriend Frank will ask in place. So, I've given Frank an alternate question. It replaces the one that Monica stopped. If you are truthful, it'll be worth $100,000, and I hope, Warren, that that is a gamble that's worth it for you. So, ex-boyfriend Frank, once again, question 15.
Do you believe I'm the man you should be married to?
I want to be honest and say yes.
That answer is... true.
I'm not sure what to say. You've answered 15 questions truthfully. You've won $100,000. First of all, Frank, is there anything you want to say at this point?
No, there's really nothing else I can really hear, so might as well just go for it.
How does it feel to be the same sex as Donald Trump?
she gets into that situation where she's banging another guy on the regular and you're suspicious of it, but you can't really tell and you don't want to be judgmental, you don't want to ruin the trust nest or whatever the fuck we're calling it. What's happened is the guy that she is cheating on you with becomes the guy that she feels bad about when you actually, as her husband or her boyfriend, or whatever, are having sex with her. So he's the one, the guy who's on the side, he's the one that she really wants to get with. That's where her desire is. And so having sex with her husband feels like cheating on the guy that she has on the side, the guy that she's actually cheating with.
Has warned the United States to avoid the Taiwan Straits.
Does China realize who they're fucking with? Because we got economic turmoil and division brewing on the home front, and we're sitting at home. We haven't been at war for almost a year. We're fucking bored. We need a distraction.
America, these colors don't run and whatnot.
On.
Yeah?
Once I can take it up the ass, come on. Harder. Harder. Harder.
That's hard. What the fuck? What do you want?
Take it off.
Ah, oh, come on. You want to stop now? That's enough. Okay.
Come on. Come
fuck on. Around, man. Come on. Hey, good.
Right. I'm going to smack you again. Throw it again.
That's enough. That's enough.
Hard.
Nah, your fucking cuts are opening and everything. What are you trying to prove? What is the proof?
Just got out of the shower, peeked out the window to see if Blake had made any progress. Figured he'd still have like 5 hours left, and I see this.
Chosen one, the boy may be. Nevertheless, grave danger I fear in his training.